We're now going to take a look at a particularly challenging factorial problem. Here's the problem. How many zeros are there at the end of 320 factorial? Now, if you didn't know anything about factorials, you take a look at this problem, you go, how many zeros are there at the end of 320? Well, that's easy. There's just one. It's right there. I found it. But once you do know about factorials, you realize what this exclamation point is, well, then you have a much more challenging and much more interesting problem. And you might start off by saying, well, let's just figure out what 320 factorial is. Count the zeros at the end. We have 320 times 319, 318, and so on down to 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Then we multiply it out. We have 320 times 319 times 3. Yeah, that's going to take a long time. We probably don't want to do that. But this does remind me, back when I was in high school, I was at a summer program once with a student who had this amazing talent for multiplying out huge products. So a group of students, we offered him $20 to multiply out 100 factorial with a pencil and paper. So he sat down, started multiplying out the numbers. Then after about 25 minutes, well, some of the instructors found out what was going on, and they came over and paid him $20 to stop. At which point, well, the rest of us, well, we started out multiplying out 100 factorial, hoping they'd pay us to stop too. That didn't work, and this probably isn't going to work for us in solving this problem. So we're going to have to think a little bit harder about this. Zeros at the end of numbers, how does that happen? Well, that happens when you multiply by 10. 14 times 10, you get 140. Zero at the end. So you think, well, let's just count up the multiples of 10. There's 10, there's 20, 30, 40, and up to 320. So obviously there are 32 of these multiples of 10, so maybe there are just 32 zeros in 320 oh. But wait a second. I see this 5 and a 2. And when we multiply 5 and 2, well, anytime you take a 5 and a 2, you multiply them, you get a 10, and that's going to give us another 0. And then there's 15, same thing's going to happen. I'm going to end up multiplying that by some even number, get another 10, and oh boy, back to the drawing board. Looks like what we need to worry about are the 2s and the 5s. Now, there are probably going to be way, way more 2s, so let's just think about the 5s first. You know, maybe if we can count how many 5s, how many factors of 5 there are here, well, then we can just pair them up with 2s and make 10s. So we'll start by counting up the multiples of 5 in this list. Number 5s, let's see. Well, if we just look at it as groups of 5, 1 through 5, 6 through 10, 11 through 15, and so on, each of these groups of 5 ends in a multiple of 5. So we have 320. We just divide that by 5. 300 divided by 5 is 60. 20 divided by 5 is 4. 60 and 4 is 64, and we see that there are 64 groups of 5 numbers here. So there are 64 multiples of 5. Well, before we write down the answer and just say, okay, there's 64 zeros at the end, we should stop and think for a minute, because we already tricked ourselves once just by counting the multiples of 10. So let's think about these multiples of 5. Make sure we have them all. So you get 5, you get 10, 15, 20, 25, 25. 25 has 2 factors of 5. So if we just count the multiples of 5, we miss those extra factors. So we have to go back and count them too. We have to worry about the number of multiples of 25 in this list. Now, how many of them are there? Well, there are just 4 for each 100. 25, 50, 75, 100. We've got 3 hundreds. That gives us 12. And then the next one's 325. Not in the list. So there are 12 multiples of 25 in this list. Well, since we had to think about the numbers with 2 factors of 5, we should think about the ones with 3 and 4 and so on. The first number with 3 factors of 5 is just 5 times 5 times 5. And of course, that's 125. So we need to worry about the multiples of 125 in this list. Fortunately, they're easy to count. There's 125. The next one's 250. Next one after that is 375, which is not in the list. We have 2. Multiples of 125 here. Then 4, we have to worry about 4 factors of 5 in a single number. Well, the first one there is 5 times 5 times 5 times 5. It's 25 squared, 625. That's way outside this list. So we don't have to worry about any more. But now what do we do? We have our multiples of 5, multiples of 25, multiples of 125, and we want to count the number of factors here. Well, if we look at our multiples of 25, we count our multiples of 25 once here, because they are multiples of 5. Then we count them again here. And that's exactly what we want to do. We want to count them twice, once for each factor of 5. And the same, a similar thing happens with our 125s. We count them once here because they're multiples of 5. Count them once here because they're multiples of 25. And then we count them again here because they're multiples of 125. We count them 3 times, once for each factor of 5. And that's exactly what we want to do. So we see that if we just add these 3 numbers, we get the total number of factors of 5 in 320 factorial. When we add those up, we get 78 factors of 5 in 320 factorial. Now, we've tricked ourselves a couple times already, so before we scribble down 78 and move on to the next problem, we stop and think and make sure, okay, we do have 78 factors of 5. We're pretty confident of that. Do we have enough 2s to make the 10s? Unfortunately, we can answer that really quick. 320 numbers in the list. Every other one is even, so that means there are 160 even numbers. That's a lot of 2s. It's at least 160 2s. So we can pair off enough 2s with these 78 5s to make 78 10s. And 78 10s, well, 78 10s give us 78 zeros at the end of 320 factorial. But wait, there's more. Not more zeros, but there's more to this problem. Let me show you a slicker way to do it. Take the 320 and divide by 5. And that gives us 64. And then we take this 64 and we divide that by 5. And that gives us 12 with a remainder of 4. Unfortunately, this is one of those times when we can ignore the remainder. I like ignoring the remainder. And we take that 12 and we divide that by 5. And we get 2. With a remainder of 2, which we're going to ignore. We take 2 divided by 5, we get 0 with a remainder 2. And that means we're done. We can ignore that remainder too. Oh, look at those numbers. 64, 64, 12, 12, 2, 2. Is it a coincidence? Well, probably not. I wouldn't show it to you if it were just a coincidence. And if you don't trust me, that's a good thing. Test it out. Try it with some other numbers. Count the number of factors of 3 in 500 factorial. Do it this way. Do it the long way, and then do it with this faster method over here, and see if you end up getting the same numbers. If you don't, check your arithmetic. And then when you do get the same numbers, well, then try to figure out what's going on here. Why do these numbers come up the same? And you'll have to figure it out because I'm not going to tell you because I wouldn't want to spoil all the fun. ¶¶